Já se jmenuji Lukáš Pekarek.
Hello, my name is Lukáš Pekarek and I'm one of the creators of the Asana suction system. Next to me is Dr. Vít Pajma. Lukáš and I started this project together. With the arrival of the COVID-19 pandemic, we had to deal with new challenges. One of them was infectious aerosol particles, something which is difficult to avoid in our line of work. Obviously, we suited up, used respirators and face shields, because we need to treat every patient as a potentially infectious one. However, we still have to use various rotary tools, which need to be cooled down by a constant flow of water. Water mixes with pressurized air and the patient's saliva, even traces of blood in some cases, into a potentially infectious aerosol. In the form of a hardly visible light mist, aerosol particles could travel as far as 8 meters from the patient's mouth. Our goal was to find a solution that would allow us to catch the substance right at the source. So this is why we started to work on a custom-made suction system. We started with a simple suction head, which can be easily attached to the patient's lower lip, allowing the wide inlet to capture aerosol particles. We made the first prototypes with an FDM 3D printer. I kept fine-tuning the design based on our testing and new ideas. Then I sent the model to Dr. Pajma and he printed it in his office and we kept on testing. The great thing about this technology is that based on the feedback I received, I was able to modify the design the very same day and send a new file back. We have published the file online at prusaprinters.org, so everyone can download it for free. We have also made our 3D printers available to our colleagues, so they could print these parts and the demand was unbelievable. The COVID suction head had a major issue though, it didn't hold in the patient's mouth on its own and had to be held by a nurse. That was yet another challenge to overcome and we solved that by designing a new suction head attached to a flexible holder. We call it Asana. Thanks to the flexible extension, the suction head can be positioned exactly as needed and there's no need to hold it by hand anymore. Soon we switched from FDM 3D printing to SLA. FDM is great, it's cheap and reasonably quick, however from a hygiene point of view, it's not suitable. Objects printed using the FDM method cannot be sterilized in our autoclave, because they can't withstand high temperatures. SLA, on the other hand, allows us to produce objects using biocompatible resins, which are temperature resistant and they can be sterilized in the autoclave. Also, these materials are certified to be used in a patient's mouth. We use Formlabs Dental SG, which is a very tough biocompatible material. When used in the original Prusa SL1, the resulting objects are very smooth with minimal tendency to collect foreign matters on their surface. We also use 3D resins and CO2 because these resins can be mixed with additives, such as colors or accelerators. The rest of the parts of the Asana suction system are printed using Prusa resin Tough White, which is a very strong material, however it's not very tough and tends to be brittle. So this is why we have the flexible resin here. We started experimenting with mixed resins and after some fine-tuning, we came up with a material ideal for our project. The resulting objects will not deform easily and I can attach one part to another and everything holds together well. And this part is made on an FDM 3D printer with PETG filament. While this part is a product we order from our suppliers and we have it manufactured in white color. As for the original Prusa SL1, I'm very happy with the quality of the build and the prints. Even though it could be faster and have at least a slightly bigger build volume, when it comes to the hardware and the way the SL1 is built, it's great. It's stable, the controls are intuitive, and the print quality is really good. Here you can see how the suction heads are being printed. We print without supports, so that's something we need to keep in mind when designing the models. However, an object that requires no supports can save you a lot of time during the actual production process, so it's definitely worth it. As a doctor, I truly appreciate the suction head. It's a great tool which can be produced quite quickly. This is very useful because we are required to dispose of every suction head immediately after use and replace it with a new one. It's great how quickly we can fine-tune the design. I can just ask Lukáš to adjust the shape and he can do it right away. Plus, the entire device is not some kind of a black box. We can disassemble it, change various parts, make it better, since there's always some room for improvements. For us, this is a great solution, and thanks to the way the whole setup is designed, it doesn't get in the way during my work. The technology is great for these applications. When it comes to other ways of using 3D printing in dentistry, I think we are still limited by the materials that are currently available on the market. The objects lack the required durability, they cannot withstand biting down on them. However, there are other ways how to utilize 3D printers in this field. For instance, I can convert computed tomography scans into STL files. This allows me to print a model of a tooth or even an entire jaw before I proceed to the surgery. The images shown on the screen are great, but to have something physical, something I can touch and examine, is a whole different story. It gives me a much better overview of the entire situation. This way, dentists can get acquainted with a patient's teeth, or even with the bones or the entire skull prior to a complicated operation. This helps to speed up the entire process and lower potential risks thanks to a better overview of the situation. It's also possible to print various accessories and tools that can help during the procedure. I'm talking mainly about various guides for rotary or cutting tools. Again, this speeds up the procedure, which means the patient does not have to be anesthetized for so long. A thorough preparation allows the doctor to work with greater confidence and precision.